Welcome top news today.
Cotabato City Bangsamoro leaders coming from several organizations gathered here on Saturday to show their vehement opposition and protest, and to show their solidarity with the Palestinian people against U.S. President Donald Trump's recent pronouncement recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's new capital. Trump's unilateral recognition immediately drew protest from several Islamic countries. A Bangsamoro Forum on Jerusalem issue, organized by Bangsamoro Action Against Injustices BAAI in Cotabato City on December 20, about 188 Bangsamoro leaders representing various organizations attended the event. According to Abdulaziz bin Hassim of the Luaran Interactive, the BAAI is a group of multi-sectoral organizations most of whose members are ulama or learned Muslims sympathetic to the cause of the Palestinian people. In an opening statement by Noamir bin Hussein, chairman of the BAAI, he said, "The Muslim world has once again been provoked. The malicious recognition of East Jerusalem as the new capital of Israel by President Donald Trump of the United States is an insult not only to the Palestinian people but to the Muslim emanation and the international community. It is a blatant disrespect to, and disregard of the Palestinians' traditional right over the city, and major religions that hold East Jerusalem sacred." Ustad's Marhan Burhan, head of the Cotabato-based Dawah Council Islamic Call said, "This is a big issue for 1.8 billion Muslim ummah around the world. Masjid al-Aqsa, situated in East Jerusalem, is the third holiest place in Islam after Masjid al-Haram in Makkah and the Prophet's Masjid in Madinah. Masjid al-Aqsa was the first Qibla of the Muslims, and it was the destination of the beloved Prophet Muhammad during his Isra night journey before his Miraj ascension toward heaven," Ustad Burhan said in his lecture. Meanwhile, BAAI spokesman USATD Habib Usman provided inputs in his political and theological implications of Jerusalem declaration. It violates the UN Resolution 181 of 1948, which is the so-called UN Partition Plan of Palestine. It has also violated the 1993 peace agreement or the Oslo Agreement and the verdict of the International Court of Justice. It prevents the Palestinians from achieving their rights to self-determination, Usman said. He added that the declaration deprives refugees their rights to return to their homeland and increases the historical injustices committed against the Palestinian people by Israel and the United States. Such injustices, according to Usman, will encourage more violent extremism. One of the resource persons in the one-day forum, Zulkarnain Abbas, gave inputs on the essentials of sympathizing with the Palestinian people on the issue of statehood and the issue of Jerusalem. In his lecture, Abbas noted, "The issue of Palestine in general, and East Jerusalem in particular, extends beyond religious symbolism toward justice and self-determination. History witnessed the Zionist people occupying Palestine, grabbing Palestinian lands, subjugating, and oppressing their people including old folks, women and children," he said. "The United Nations has been proven inutile in stopping these atrocities, and Israel has acted with impunity," Abbas added. He said the Israeli government has constructed illegal settlements meant to dispossess the Palestinians of their lands, conducted warrantless arrests, jailed and tortured innocent civilians, imposed an economic blockade on Palestinian territories, among other abuses. To say that Israel has committed human rights abuses is understatement, for it has committed crimes against humanity. It has upgraded itself from being a rogue state to being a prime example of a living terrorist state," Abbas pointed out. Boycott. During an open forum, the participants made a strong recommendation to the group not to patronize products from the U.S. and Israel as a response to Trump's decision. They even asked the BAAI to make a fatwa or religious edict that prohibits Muslims from buying any products from coming from the U.S. and Israel. The participants urged reaching out to other groups and sectors, including Christians, to strengthen indignation protests against such recognition. Writing a formal letter or manifesto to be submitted to the U.S. and Israeli embassies in Manila was also suggested during the forum. Manifesto. Another Muslim leader, Drive Umbra Imam, read a manifesto as expression of the group's sympathy and solidarity with the Palestinian people in their struggle to reclaim their land and their rights to self-determination. "As a people whose lands were illegally occupied, who lived under subjugation for more than three centuries, and who are asserting their rights to self-determination, we, the concerned Bangsamoro leaders, denounce this move by U.S. President Trump in the strongest terms possible, and call on him to reverse his move. We call on all countries in the world to stop the terrorism of the Zionists and their allies against the Palestinian people by all means possible. We strongly support the initiatives and actions of the world leaders regarding this issue. Moreover, we call on the entire Muslim Ummah to unite, preserve and protect the holy site, our beloved Bayt al-Maqdis, which Zionists are so keen on destroying through whatever means possible. This is a duty incumbent upon us, a duty that needs to be upheld, for a day may come when we may be made answerable before Allah, the Almighty, part of the group's manifesto said.